In this beginner sculpting follow along tutorial, we're going to be sculpting this orc head in Blender. Now, this tutorial is geared towards beginners, but if you're a complete beginner and you've never done sculpting before, then you should probably go check out my sculpting in Blender for beginners tutorial. There'll be a card up on the screen for that, and I just go over all the brushes and all the things that you need to know to get started with sculpting in Blender. But let's go ahead and sculpt this orc. So I'm right here in Blender. I also have my drawing tablet right in front of me. And I have my drawing pen and my drawing glove. If you want to see the different stuff that I recommend, there will be Amazon links in the video description to some tablets and like the drawing glove that I recommend. And those are Amazon affiliate links, but they won't cost you anything extra if you purchase something through those links. And then I also have my keyboard right next to me so that I can press the Control and Shift keys while I'm sculpting. So let's just start off here. I'm going to just turn on my screencast keys. So that you can see right down here, you can see what buttons I'm pressing right down there in the corner. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just press A to select everything and then press X and delete it. I'm going to press Shift A now, and I'm going to add a UV sphere, and that's what I'm going to use to sculpt the orc. Now I want to add more detail because you can see that there isn't very much geometry here. So I'm going to click on Add Modifier, go to the Modifier tab right here, Add Modifier, and I'm going to add a subdivision surface. I'm just going to turn these both up to 2, and then with my mouse over the modifier, Control A, that applies the modifier. Now if I tab into edit mode, you can see that there's a lot more geometry. So now what I can do here with this, just this sphere in the very center here, is I can go over with the selected, go over here to the sculpting tab right above you. And you can see now we're in sculpt mode. Now this little gizmo up here, I don't really care to use it. So what I'm going to do is press this button to close it. If you want to use it, you can. You can just like pull this around to rotate and stuff, but I don't really use these things. I just use shortcut keys. So I'm just going to close that. I'll just zoom in here. So you can see here's the brushes here. I'm just going to click and pull this out just that I can see more of the brushes. And then also I'm going to change the matte cap because this white matte cap, I don't really like this too much. So to change this, I'm going to click right here. And then you can see there's matte cap. I've added in a lot of matte caps, and some of these I actually made myself. If you want to watch my tutorial on how to make matte caps, I'll add a card up on the screen right there. But I like to use this matte cap. It's built into Blender. It's this nice red matte cap. I just think this really gives me a good preview of the mesh when we're sculpting. So you can use whichever one you want. I'm going to use this one. Okay, let's turn on the Dyne Topo now. So I'm just going to scroll down here. You can see it says Dyne Topo. I'm going to turn this on, press OK. Open up the setting down here, and you can see the detail size is at 12. I'm going to change it to like 3. If that's a little too hard on your computer, if it's lagging a little bit, then you may need to turn it up. You can see if I just sculpt now, you can see that's how detailed it is. Okay, so what I'm going to do first is just make the basic head proportions of a male face or a male skull, and then I'm going to change it to make it look more like an orc. But how an orc is created, like how it's stylized, it does look like a human, but then it has some proportional changes, like, you know, it has like a bigger jaw and they might have really big teeth or something. So we're going to start off with realism, and then we'll kind of make it a bit stylized after that. And I would definitely encourage you to go ahead and grab reference images. So you just want to go online, look for some different reference images, because reference images can be really helpful to making your sculpts look better. So I would definitely recommend that. Just have some reference images up. Hopefully you might have like a second monitor, or maybe you have like a phone or a tablet or something. You could look at some references, or maybe even have like a book with some pictures. You could look at that or whatever. But yeah, references are super important. So definitely go ahead and grab some. And just make sure also that the symmetry is on, because the orc face is pretty similar on both sides, so we don't have to sculpt both of the sides. So you can click on this little X button right up here, and then that way, when we sculpt on this side, it's going to be mirrored on the other side, because for the majority of the face, it's the same on either side. So that'll save time and make it a bit easier to sculpt. So I'm just going to pull down the jaw here, and remember to look at it around from all sides, because when I was first pulling this down, it was like way too far out. So I had to like pull it back in. So just look it around, look around at your sculpt from different angles. So I'm just going to start by sculpting out a little bit more of realistic proportions of just like a male face, and then we'll stylize it to look like a orc. Now you can see here that the side of the face, or the side of the head, is kind of coming way out. I don't really want this, so I'm just gonna, again, using the grab brush, I'm just gonna bring this in here. Okay, I'm gonna go into the clay strips brush, make my brush smaller. I'm actually going to turn this button off and this button off, because these buttons, I don't really want them. What this button does is it makes each brush have the same size. So when I switch brushes, it'll be the same size. I don't really want that. And then also this here, this makes the brush bigger or smaller, depending on how hard you press it. I don't really want that to be turned on. So I'm just going to turn both of these off. Okay, so now that I'm on the clay strips, I'm also going to turn the auto smooth right here to 0.1. You don't have to do this if you don't want to, but I think it just is a little bit nicer to make the mesh a little bit smoother. So when I sculpt, it's going to auto smooth it and kind of smooth it out as I sculpt. So what I'm going to do now is hold down control and start to just carve in kind of where the eyes are. Okay, and then also I think I'll make it a little bit flatter right here. Kind of carve in right here. The cheekbone is right here, so I'll just have that come out a little bit. Okay. Carve that in a bit. Kind of make a little bit of a chin. Okay. Maybe carve this in. So this is going to kind of be the back of the head and the skull, so bring that in a little bit, and we will add a neck and some shoulders later on. Okay, I'm just going to make kind of the bony part on the top of the nose. So I'm just going to go around here, kind of bring that in. I think I'll just turn the auto smooth off for now. There we go. We can smooth that out later. Okay, so there is the nose. Go in a little bit on that. Okay, and then the mouth comes out a bit. So I'm going to just go like this, because the mouth actually curves around the face. It's not flat. It actually curves around the face. I'm going to have it coming out a little bit here. Then hold down control, have it going in a little bit there. And there is that cheekbone right up here. So then right in here, it kind of goes in. You might be able to see on my face. The cheekbone is right here. Then there's an open space where your teeth are right there. So I'm just going to have that go in a little bit. Okay. Definitely looking at like anatomy references can really help. Because even though an orc isn't really a human and we're making a stylized orc, it still is really helpful to look at real world reference. So if you can look at like facial anatomy and stuff like that, that can really help. I'm going to keep carving in here because I want these to be farther in. And then I'm just going to hold down the shift key and just lightly smooth over this. If you're using a mouse, then this is going to be kind of hard. I definitely would recommend using a drawing tablet if you can get one, or maybe you already have one. The orcs' noses are usually a little bit different. They're usually not so far down. They're kind of like pushed up and smaller. So what I'm going to do is just start to sculpt in right here, kind of this area of the nose, and then kind of go around this area too. And then I'm going to hold down control, kind of carve in the nostril here. Okay, now you can see this is very flat if you look at it kind of on the side. I want to pull it out. So I'll press G for the grab brush, F, make my brush just a little bit bigger, and then I'll kind of pull this up and out a little bit. Although it seems like orcs' noses are usually a little bit stubby. Kind of pull that out so it's a little bit more round. Okay, let's save this project. I actually haven't saved this yet. Let's go File and Save As. Okay, I'm just going to save this as orc.blend. Save as. Okay, let's keep going here. So I think I want to add in the ears now. So what I'm going to do is use the draw brush right here, and then I'm going to kind of go along. So I think I want the ear to kind of start up here, kind of the same where the eyes are, and then it's going to kind of meet at the jaw. Kind of go around here. Just kind of pull it out, and we'll kind of detach it from the side of the head shortly. And usually orcs have pointy ears. Okay, so right here, I'm kind of just sculpting around this, but I need to kind of carve in here. So I'm just going to hold down control with the draw brush. I think the draw brush works really well, and carve in where the ear is, just so that it's kind of detached from the head. And then use the smooth brush by holding down shift, going around here, smoothing that out. Okay, and then let's look at it from front view. You can see something looks wrong here. I'm gonna press G for the grab brush and kind of pull up the pointy ear, pull that up a little bit. Pull it back a little bit too, because it's kind of coming out too far. Okay, that's better. Maybe bring this back a little bit more. Maybe hold down the shift key, kind of smooth that out just a little bit. And then I'm going to go back to the draw brush. Kind of just smooth that out a bit. And make that attach to the head right there. All right, so orcs, at least the orc that I'm going to make, is going to have like a bigger jaw, bigger than, you know, normal people, of course. So I'm going to pull out the jaw. So I'll press G to go to the grab brush, and I will pull that out. I'm going to make it a really sharp jaw. So it's going to come down, kind of come out here, because it needs to kind of fit those big teeth. So I'm just going to pull that out, make a really strong jaw. Also, orcs are usually kind of dumb, at least I think they probably usually are. So I'm going to pull this in a little bit to make their head look a little bit smaller, like they have smaller brains because they're dumb. Maybe there's some smart orcs, but I think most orcs are a little dumb. Okay, just kind of make that, you can see there, it's kind of a little bit smaller right there. Okay, we got a nice big jaw. Let's go ahead and carve in the mouth now. So let me just go file and save. And then I'm going to grab the clay strips, just zoom into the mouth here, and I'm going to hold down control, start carving in there. A nice big mouth to fit those big scary orc teeth. Just carve way back. Also, I think using the drawbrush, when you get really back there, I think using the drawbrush actually works kind of better. I'm just going to hold down control, go way back in there for the mouth. Hold down the shift key and kind of smooth out that area because it's pretty rough. Okay, keep on going. Okay, now I want to kind of shape the mouth a little bit now that we've kind of made it. So I'm going to press G to go to the grab brush, kind of just shape it. Have the front of it kind of coming out and then the back of it coming in because the mouth and the teeth really curve around the face. The face isn't flat, it's very round. And also, because the teeth kind of come up in front of the rest of the head, I want to make this bottom area even farther out. So I'm just going to pull this out, maybe pull this back a little bit so that there's kind of an area for the teeth to kind of come out in front. Okay, I'm going to go file and save this again, and then let's go ahead and add the eyes because I definitely think we need to add the eyes in sooner rather than later. So what I'm going to do is just go back here to the layout. And then just zoom over here. I'll press Shift C, and Shift C is going to make sure that 3D cursor is in the center of the scene. And then I'll press Shift A, and I'm going to go and add a UV sphere. And let's tab into edit mode here. I'm going to press R to rotate, X on the X axis, and type in 90 for 90 degrees, and then enter. And then I'll press S, scale it down. G to grab, and just stick it right in there. It's a little too big right now, so I'll scale it down, move it into place. Definitely don't make the eyes too big. Okay, I'm just trying to find the exact right point, or as best as I can. Let's see, I think they should be a little bit smaller. Okay. Now I will tab into object mode. Let's go add modifier on the modifiers panel, and I'm going to add a mirror modifier, and then I will shade the object smooth. And then let's see, if I go 3 for side view, I think it's a little too far back, so I'm going to tab back into object mode or edit mode, press G and just bring it out a little bit more, not too far. Okay, just zoom in here. I'm going to alt select this loop, so hold down alt and select this loop, hold down alt and shift and select this loop, and then just hold down shift and select this loop. Okay, so now we have all these selected. I'm going to press E and actually bring it back a little bit, and then S and scale it down a little bit, and then I'm just gonna alt select this loop and then shift and select this loop. I'll press G and X, nope, G and Y, bring it back a little bit. Now you can see because we shaded it smooth, it's very kind of weird looking. So I'll tab into edit mode, press Control R, and add a loop cut right there. You can definitely use your mouse for this. I'm just using my tablet, but it's a little bit harder to use my tablet. So I'm just going to press Control R, add a loop cut there and there. That'll sharpen up that edge. Now you can see it's a lot easier to see. Okay, so there we go. That guy's looking pretty creepy. Let's make him look a bit happier. So I'm going to go select the face and go back into sculpt mode. And then I'm going to press G for the grab brush. Kind of pull this down a little bit. So I'm going to make him a little bit happier. Okay, that's better. I feel like we could add more kind of anatomy in here because this is kind of like very rigid. It's not very interesting. The jaw is not very interesting. So I'm going to go over to the clay strips. Also, because we went back into sculpt mode now, I need to turn back on the Dyne Topo. So I'll turn that on. And then I'm just going to add, I think maybe I'll add a little dimple. So hold down control, go in there. Okay, smooth that out a little bit. Okay, now the back of the jaw, I kind of want to sharpen that up a bit. So I'm going to hold down control, kind of go in here, sharpen up that a little bit, and then S and smooth it out. Okay. Let's see, that's a little too big, so I'm going to just carve in there a little bit. Just make that a little less big. Okay. Let's go ahead and do the eyebrows now and then also the eyelids. I'm just going to go file and save this again. We can really add a lot of character into the eyelids and eyebrows. So I'm going to just kind of go around like this. Okay. And then also hold down control, kind of carve in an angle right here. Also, what I could do is use the scrapes brush and kind of cut in here and kind of scrape away clay. You could also use the flatten brush too. Make my brush a little bit bigger. Kind of cut in that angle there. I'm going to try the flatten brush too. I'm just going to make the nose a little bit flatter there. Okay. And then I'll go back to the clay strips. And I'm going to just kind of go in here. I'm just going to go in there, make those eyebrows a bit bigger. Okay. Oh, now he looks scared. let's add the eyelids now. So I'm going to go to the clay strips and I'll just go along here, start to add that. Now, you know, the eyes are very round, so I'm just going to go around like this and make sure that it's I want to make the eyebrows look like they're, you know, being kind of pulled around the eye. So I'm going around like this, bringing that down. I'm also going to go like this. Just keep on building up clay here, and it'll come through the eye. Also, let's go in here, add some clay here, make those a little bit bigger underneath his eyes. Now I'm going to press G, go to the grab brush, zoom in here, kind of pull this down a little bit. So it's kind of going around the eye a little bit more. There we go. Okay, now right here, I want there to kind of be kind of a lip or kind of like a cliff edge almost. If I go to the clay strips, I can hold down control and just kind of go along here. And then what I'm going to do is use the crease brush right here and then hold down control and go along here, and that'll kind of sharpen up that edge of the eyebrow. And then I can hold down shift, just smooth that out a little bit, and then just go in here with the crease brush, kind of crease the edge of the eye. Okay, and then I want to crease this too. Kind of add some bags under his eyes. Okay, and smooth that out a little bit. Okay, let's do the same thing for the top of the eyelid. So I'm going to hold down control, kind of make that pop out a little bit. And if your computer can't quite go this high detail, that is okay. You can just turn it down. Like if I do this at like a 6, it still works. Let me just, I'm going to go to the clay strips brush and kind of go in here. Just make that a little bit smoother and then hold down the shift key. Okay, I'm going to change this detail back up to 3. Hold down control, go in here. I'm going to add some more of the eyebrow kind of coming down. Like this, just going along the eyebrow. Okay, so I want to work on the nose a little bit more. Let me just go file and save this again. So for the nose here, I feel like it's a little bit too long. I kind of want to have it coming over a little bit, kind of over itself. So I'm going to press G to get to the grab brush, bring it down a little bit, and then bring this up a little bit. Just because it was a little bit extreme. Okay, and then I do want to have this kind of going down a lot, kind of hanging over a little bit. Okay, I'm going to go to the draw brush and kind of go around here. Just make that pop a little bit. Okay, and then we need to add kind of the crease in there where the wings of the nose are, kind of behind the wings of the nose. So I'm going to hold down control with my draw brush. Kind of go in there. You could also use the crease brush for this. That would work really well too. Just go in there. Okay, just smooth that out a little bit now, holding down the shift key. Okay, and then this kind of area right here, I want to pull that down. So I'll go back to the grab brush, pull it down, and maybe a little bit back. Okay, let's go ahead and smooth this out a bit. So I'm going to go to the clay strips, just add a little bit more clay here, and then hold down the shift key, smooth that out. Okay. There we go. Okay, now I do want to add some creases right here, because like when you smile, you can see there's those creases right there. So I'm going to add some more skin right here and then just go along it, kind of go along the side of it and just kind of go up, add more skin right there, and then we'll add a crease right in there. If I just hold down control, I can kind of go in and make that go back in a little bit and then go along here, kind of have that coming up a little bit. This might be a good place to turn the auto smooth to like a 0.1. And then that way you can see it's kind of smoothing it out as you go. That's a little bit better. He's looking a little bit more happy. I'm going to go to the crease brush, go in here, going to add a nice big crease right there. Okay, now I think I want to make his jaw a little bit smaller because it's pretty wide right now. So I'm going to press G for the grab brush. Kind of bring it in a little bit. Not too much, but I think it is a little bit too wide. Okay, let's save this again. I'm going to go file and save. It's definitely looking better. And then, yeah, I really like how this is very sharp. So adding that in there, kind of coming down, then coming over, I think that helps the orc to look better. And right now the chin looks really big, but we will be adding like the neck and the back and stuff. Okay, let's go ahead and do that actually. So I'm going to do the neck now. So let's go file and save this again, and then go to the clay strips. Actually, I'm going to go to the draw brush. I think it works better for doing big stuff. And then I'm just going to go around, make circles kind of back here where the neck would be, and kind of start to just bring that down. It's kind of funny when you start to add that because his neck is like really thin. But we'll sharpen that up and we'll add like some neck muscles. If you want to use the snake hook, this brush right here, make it really big and just pull down this more. That can really help using that snake hook brush. And then I'm going to pull this out a bit to make the shoulders. Kind of want to make some big shoulders. And I do want to make him kind of look like he has a kind of a big back kind of coming over. I think that makes him look a lot more. It's sort of like what a cave troll maybe would look like, or a troll or something. So I'm going to pull this out here as well. I'm going to go back to the grab brush and kind of pull out the back of the neck and kind of bring the back up a bit, and the shoulders kind of bring him up, make him look really buff. This can really help to make him look better. So just pull that up. It's almost like the back of his head just kind of goes into his back. Okay. All right, there we go. So now back here, you can see I've just been pulling this up, and so it's kind of has a sharp angle right there. I just want this to kind of transition a little bit nicer. So I'm going to go to the clay strips, just kind of go in here. There we go. Maybe hold down control. That's a little bit pointy, so I'll just bring that back a little bit. Okay. Go in there. And then I want to add those two. There's two really big muscles. You may be able to see them. When you kind of turn, you can see there's a big muscle right here. And that's used to like turn the head and stuff. So I'm going to go to the clay strips. Now that muscle, it starts like right below the ear and it kind of comes down kind of into the center here on the top of your chest. So I'm going to just pull this down, just kind of show the area that I want to make it. And it's on both sides. So right here and right here. And then I'll just go sideways and kind of sculpt along it. There we go. And I do have the auto smooth on 0.1. I think I'll leave it for now. Go along there, make a nice big muscle, neck muscles. Okay. And then there's also the clavicles, which are those two bones that are kind of coming like this. So I will add those kind of coming like this, and then they kind of curve in there. Just go along here and add those. Let's save this again. So I'm gonna go file and save, okay. And let's also add the Adam's apple. So I'm going to bring that kind of out. I think I also want to add like some wrinkles, but we'll go ahead and do that later. But I want to add some wrinkles a few different places. There's the wrinkles here, some wrinkles here, but I do want to add some like wrinkles where the neck is. Give him a little more skin or fat there. This is kind of coming out. It's kind of too long, so I'm just going to hold down control and go back in a little bit. Okay. Yeah, he's really starting to look like an orc. I want to make this muscle a little bit bigger, kind of up here. Okay, I don't know if this is happening with you, but there's like a big kind of empty space right here. So I'm just going to carve that in. Make it attach, kind of add, I think there's like some muscles or something that kind of go along here. I'm just going to go along there. Let's see, I want to make this a little bit thicker, so I'll just carve in there. Oh, so you can see this is happening. I'm just going to control Z that. Hopefully that didn't happen with you. So why this is happening is because you can see when I sculpt here. Oh, it's not doing it right now. Sometimes it does it. There we go, starting to do it. So what I'll do for this is these, I guess, are just a little too close to each other. So I'm going to go to the inflate brush, and I'll do the inflate brush instead. And that way you can see it's not going to pull that in. It's just inflating the mesh, and then smooth that out. Yeah, it's kind of annoying, but sometimes that happens. So I'll just use the inflate brush, go along here, kind of make that a bit thicker, this whole area. Okay, now I think I want his ears to kind of come out a little bit more. So I'm going to press G, go to the grab brush, kind of pull this out a little bit more, kind of make his ears a little bit pointy, and kind of maybe have them kind of falling down a little bit, kind of sagging a little bit. That might make it look kind of funny. Okay, that's make it a little bit pointier. There we go. Let's go ahead and do just a little bit of detail in here. So I'm going to go to the draw brush. F, make my brush smaller, and just kind of go in here, and then hold down control and add the hole in the ear, and then just add something right there. Also, I think I'll hold down control and go along here, just kind of curve that in a bit. I think I want to make his head a little bit more blocky. So I'm going to go to the clay strips brush, kind of go along here, not too blocky, but just a little bit. So I'm going to hold down control, kind of make the top of his head a little bit flatter, and then go along the sides here. Just kind of make that a little bit more blocky, and then hold down the shift key and smooth that out. Okay, now I think his jaw, I think it's actually a little too far out right now, or his chin is a little too far out. So I'm going to press G to go to the grab brush and just pull that jaw back a little bit. Maybe pull it up a little bit too. And I want to bring this up a little bit. I think we better add the teeth now, though, and then we can kind of finish up the shape of the mouth, but we kind of need to know where the teeth are going to be. Okay, so let's go to object mode, and then let's go back to the layout here. Again, I'll press Shift-C, And that'll just center the 3D cursor in there. I'll press Shift A, and I'm going to add a circle. On the circle settings here, I'm just going to change this to like 8 on the vertices here, because we don't need that much to work with. Make that a bit smaller. Now to model this, I'm not going to use my drawing tablet because that's a little bit hard. So I'm just going to use my mouse and keyboard, which are kind of on the side here. So I'm going to press G and click with my middle mouse wheel, bring this out. We'll scale it down a little bit. This is going to be the starting of the tooth, so I'm going to extrude that up. So I'll bring that kind of down right here, and then I'll tab into edit mode. Just bring this over kind of where the tooth would be. We're going to make that big tooth on the side there. Okay, let's press E and extrude this up. Maybe bring the whole thing out a little bit. Alt, I'm going to alt select this loop. Scale it down a little bit, and then I'll press E. R to rotate, we'll just scale that down. Let's just do that one more time. So E to extrude, S to scale, and then F to fill that. Okay, now the normals need to be recalculated. So I'm going to tab into edit mode, select everything, and press Shift N. That'll recalculate the normals. Okay, now we need to add a subsurf modifier. So I'll click on add modifier here. Going to add subdivision surface, and then we'll just shade that mesh smooth. Okay, now I want this to be even rounder, so I'm going to tab into edit mode and just alt select this loop, press R and rotate it over a little bit, and then alt select this loop and bring it out a bit. Double tap A, kind of bring it in into his mouth here. This top area, I'm going to just pull it out a little bit. All right, now I want to add a mirror modifier so that his teeth are mirrored to the other side, so I'm going to click on add modifier, add the mirror. There we go, now it's mirrored to the other side. Just gonna double tap R, rotate it a little bit. What do you think? Something like that looks good. Maybe just make the teeth a little bit bigger. Yeah, something like that. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is in edit mode, I'm gonna press Shift D and then scale it down. Just make some small teeth that you can just barely see. And pull these inside the mouth a little bit more. Just like that, just little teeth. And then again, I can press Shift D and Shift D again. Now to bring these all up a little bit, I'll press L and L with my mouse on these teeth, and then press G and bring them up a little bit. Okay, and then if we want to duplicate these to make some more teeth on the front here, I just want to actually move these back a little bit because the front teeth go over the back teeth. So I'll press Shift D with these selected, bring them up. And then I'm just going to hit R and rotate these around. And now they're pointed down and kind of interline them. Make them in between the other teeth. So I'm just going to bring them over like that. Okay, how's that looking? Oh yeah, menacing sharp teeth. So I'm just going to leave that there for now. So let's select the face, and then I'm going to go back into sculpt mode now. Just going to grab my drawing tablet, put on the glove again. So I'm going to press G to go to the grab brush, F, make my brush a little bit smaller. And I want to pull this out just to give it a little bit more room for the teeth. Kind of bring this in here. But yeah, this area, it's a little bit close to the lip, so I'm going to just pull that out a little bit to give it some more space. Now, I want to fix his expression because there's just something I don't like about his expression. So I'm going to fix his expression a lot, we can play around with the eyebrows. So if you change the eyebrows around, that'll really change his expression. And also the eyelids, like if they're really open, he's going to look really alert. And if they're really closed, he's going to look maybe tired or sleepy or not alert or something. Okay, that's good. I want to go ahead and add in more stuff on the front of his chin and his neck. So I'm going to go to the clay strips brush, kind of add some areas right here, kind of skin and fat, and we'll add some wrinkles as well. Okay. Maybe add a little bit more mass right there. Also, to make the shoulders look like they're kind of big and strong, I'm going to go around here and kind of bump those out a bit. I need to turn on the Dyn Topo again, so right down here I'm going to click on this, press OK, and that way it'll be adding geometry as we sculpt. And then I'm going to use the grab brush and kind of pull that up just to make him look a little bit beefier. Okay, let's go ahead and add the wrinkles. So I'm going to go to the crease brush. I'm going to press F, make that a little bit bigger. I'm going to start by just adding some creases around the back here. Maybe I'll go to the grab brush and pull this out a little bit more. Okay, let's go to the clay strips brush, kind of go along here, add more skin. So it kind of looks like the skin is wrinkling on the back here. Okay. Add a little bit more right there. Okay, and then down here, just going to add a bit more. Yeah, that's better. Because I feel like before he was a little bit kind of thin on his neck. So just kind of making him look larger and more buff. So I'm actually going to do that a little bit more because I think that looks better. Maybe adding a little bit more kind of fat pads and stuff. Adding in a little bit more there. Maybe defining that muscle a bit more. I'm going to make this muscle even bigger because why not? It'll look cool. And then on the sides here, I definitely want to add more muscle right there. I might even press G to go to the grab brush and kind of pull out the sides there just to make him look even buffer. Yeah, there we go. That's really filling that out now. Okay. I'm just going to smooth this out a little bit more now, and then let's add some creases. So I'll go to the crease brush, and I'm just going to add some creases right in here. Add some creases in here, trying to add wrinkles and also define where the muscles are a little bit more. Make that brush even smaller. Kind of go along there. I like that kind of look. I'm going to hold down the control key and go along here to kind of make it look maybe like it's a bust or something, like a clay bust. And just go along this whole edge to kind of sharpen that up. And then just hold down the shift key and smooth out those edges there. Okay. Let's add a little bit of creases in here. Define this a little bit more. So add some more creases right there. Also want to add that little area right in there. So I'm just going to go around, carve that in. And then I want to smooth this out a little bit. Maybe add more creases right in here. And then this, I never really smoothed this out, so I'm just going to hold down the shift key, just lightly smooth that out there. With the crease brush, I'm just going to carve in there a little bit. And also, I think right here, let me go to the clay strips brush and just kind of cut in there. Because I feel like there shouldn't really be that area. It should kind of carve in a bit more. This guy's looking a little bit more creepy with all the wrinkles, you know? Okay, I want to go ahead and add some lips, kind of, because right now he doesn't really have much lips. So I'm going to just go along here, make that a bit thicker where his lips are. And then we'll also add some creases on the lips. Okay, just going along there. And if you wanted to, you could try using the draw brush. That might work a little bit better. Maybe not. Yeah, I'm going to go back to the clay strips and just kind of go along there. Okay. Now you can see that's a lot of room from the teeth to the lips. So I'm going to use the grab brush, kind of pull that back a little bit. Oh, let me see if I can fix this. Smooth that out. Yeah, this is kind of annoying. So what I'm going to do is go back to the inflate brush. Just inflate that out and then smooth it out. It's pretty annoying. I don't know why it happens. I guess it's just because the mesh gets too close to itself right in there. So, but I find that the inflate brush is the best thing to do to push them away from each other. I think I'll just inflate the entire lips a little bit. Smooth that out a little bit. Okay, right here, the lip is kind of going into the big tooth. So I'll press G for the grab brush and kind of pull that back a little bit. Okay, two more things I really want to work on is I still don't quite really like the shape of the eyebrows. And then also, I feel like something is wrong with the top of the head. So I'm going to start with the head here. I'm going to go to the grab brush and kind of just play around with the shapes just a little bit. It's subtle, but I like that. I think that looks kind of nice, how it kind of comes up and then down. Maybe I'll make that a little bit stronger even. But looking at it from front view, just trying to look at my reference images and see what'll make it look more like an orc. Maybe a little bit flatter on the head there. I think I want to make this a bit flatter. So first I'm going to go to the clay strips brush, make this a little bit bigger on there, and then hold down control and go in just a little bit there. Yeah, just making that shape a little bit better. That's better. And I think making the top of the head a little bit flat also looks kind of nice. Okay, now right now he looks almost a little bit horrified, like he's scared or something. Okay, so I want to change his expression now. So I want to make him look a little bit more mean. So I'm going to go to the grab brush and pull this down a little bit. Kind of make him more a little more angry. Bring this down a bit. Okay, so I just kind of pulled this down a little bit. Now he looks more angry. And also I pulled this down. So these are both kind of coming in here and here. Okay, now I'm going to go to the clay strips brush, kind of build that up to make some really, really strong eyebrows. And then making a crease in there. Okay, I'm going to go to the crease brush, kind of crease that in. Okay. And then also, we should probably add some creases on the forehead, and then also I still want to add a little bit more wrinkles and stuff on the lips. So I'm going to go along here. Kind of add a bit more wrinkles on his forehead. There we go. And then also let's try adding some wrinkles in here. Now you can see if I go right in here, it almost looks like the teeth, and this one especially, the teeth are kind of coming out of the lips, and I don't want this. So I'm going to use the grab brush and kind of pull out the lips a bit more. They have a little bit more space. Okay, that's better. There we go. All right, I really like how this is turning out. Let's go file and save again. I really enjoy sculpting. It's really fun. Of course, it is frustrating when you sculpt something for so long and then it just turns out horrible, but when it turns out, I'm pretty happy with this. When it turns out good, it's pretty fun. Bring that in a little bit. Okay, I want to add a little bit more wrinkles a few different places. So gonna add a few more wrinkles in here, a little bit more here. And I think this area here, the kind of the earlobe, kind of carve that in, make that a little bit more stand out a little bit more. All right, so to just add a little bit more detail and just make him a little bit nicer, I'm actually gonna turn off symmetry, and then I'm gonna add in a few little different things, like maybe a few scratches on his head and some things like that. So right here, I'm going to turn off the symmetry. I need to turn back on the Dyne Topo. I'm going to go to the crease brush, and I'm just going to add, like, maybe he's a little bit battle worn. He has some scratches or something. So I'm going to add right in here, add some scratches, maybe a battle wound or something. And this is also cool because that way he's not symmetrized exactly the same. Add something in right there. That's cool. Okay. And then also, if you wanted to, this is a pretty fun thing you can do. Just kind of make him look a little bit more interesting. You can just slightly change like where the eyelids and stuff are. So if I like just pull this down a little bit and then maybe pull this one up a little bit. Now he's like going, just slightly. It kind of gives him a little bit more character. And then maybe have this coming up a little bit and this going down a little bit. So he's kind of like, huh? Really just kind of makes the sculpt kind of pop, give him a bit more character. So instead of looking exactly the same on both sides, it's a bit different. Also, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to make one shoulder coming up and one shoulder going down. So this shoulder, I'm going to, I have the grab brush on and it's really big. I'm just going to bring the whole thing down a little bit, and then this, just bring this up a little bit. Also, I think I'll just play around with the ear a little bit, just to make it a little bit different. Just adding little bits of variation, you know, can really help. There we go. He really looks, he has more character now, you know? He doesn't just look like a stock sculpt and it's like, he's like exactly the same. He has a lot more character to him now. Now, because we changed where the lip was, this tooth is kind of in. So I want to pop this tooth out a little bit because it's not really in the right place. So I'm going to go back to the layout here. And then, this is looking really cool. I'm going to click on this tab into edit mode. Actually, we need to apply the mirror modifier so that I can change it a little bit. I'm going to change the levels and viewport actually up to 2 so it's a little bit smoother. And then this mirror right here, the mirror modifier, I'm just going to move my pen over this and press Control A, apply that. And then I can tab into edit mode and you can see now they're all individual. So to pull this tooth out, I'm going to press L with my mouse over it and that'll select it. And then I can press G, bring it out a little bit, R and rotate it. So press L to select it, bring it down a little bit, maybe bring it out a little bit. All right, and then this, it looks like it's kind of cutting in a little bit here. So I'm gonna tab into edit mode, A to deselect everything, press L and just select this tooth again, and just rotate it out, press G and move it out a little bit. And then I think I need to bring it over a little bit and maybe double tap R and rotate it a little bit. And if you wanted to, you could kind of make like a tooth missing or make the teeth just a little bit different if you wanted to. Let's see, right here, this is kind of coming through here. I'm going to go back into sculpt mode and with the grab brush, just kind of bring that down a little bit. Okay. Okay. And then also I think I'll add a few more creases, a few more like battle wounds or something. I'm just going to add a little bit of scratches or cuts in there. Okay. And then the last thing that I want to do is to add some little bumps on his skin. So I'm going to go to the, draw brush and make my brush somewhat small. And then I'm just going to go around here, add some little bumps on his skin. Let's see, maybe add a few on his nose. I don't want them to come out too much, but just somewhere around here, on his cheek a little bit, maybe some on his jaw. There we go. Smooth that out just a little bit. Just doing some last little finishing details to really make it pop, look kind of nice. Those are a little coming out too much, so I'm just holding down shift, smoothing those out a little bit so they're a little bit harder to see. Maybe add a few more on the front of the face. You could even add like a nose ring if you want to. I think some orcs have nose rings. If you want to model a little nose ring or something, that'd be funny. And I think on the top of the head, add a little bit more of those bumps too. And with these last few bumps, I'm just going to call this finished now. So this is it. I'm going to call this one done. So let's go file and save. I'm going to be uploading this 3D model up onto Sketchfab. So if you want to check it out, I'll have the link in the video description. If you want to like go around and look at the 3D model in Sketchfab. And also if you want to get the project files for this, it's going to be available on my Gumroad and Patreon. So links will be in the video description to that as well. If you wanted to, you could go ahead and add materials and lighting and stuff, but what I'm going to do is just render it out kind of as a sculpt in the matcap view. So to do this, I can go over here, and right now I'm in cycles. You might be in Eevee on the rendering engine. I'm going to change this over to Workbench, and what Workbench does is it renders out, basically it renders out the viewport. So you can see there's this here. If I press Z and move up, now we're in rendered mode, but because we're in Workbench, it looks just like the viewport. So I'm going to change this to matcap. And if you want to find a cool matcap that you want to use for the finished render, whoa, that looks really cool. You can see a lot of detail in there. It kind of looks like a metal orc. But I want to just go ahead and use the same one. So I'm just going to click on this. And then you can play around with some different things here. So I'm going to add the cavity and just kind of make the edges pop a little bit. There we go. Also, I'm going to turn on the outline. Just adds a tiny little outline there. And then the shadow here, if I turn on shadow, yeah, it's really starting to look nice now. So the shadow adds a shadow. So if I click on the little gear here, I can rotate the shadow around. Maybe I'll have it kind of like that and then make it a bit darker. There we go. Yeah, that's really looking cool. Okay, and then to render this out, Let me just go file and save this again. I'm going to select everything and shade that smooth. And then what I'm going to do is press Shift A. And then I'm going to add a camera. And then I'm just going to press Control Alt Number Pad 0. Control Alt Number Pad 0 is going to hop the camera to where we are. And then we can just position this around. So I'm going to press G, double tap Z and bring this out. And then press G and move this over. And then right down here, you can see there's the resolution. I'm going to bring this up a little bit. Bring that in. Okay, and then I'm leaving some space here because I want to have a different view of the sculpt. So what I'm going to do here is I have my mouse and my keyboard now. I'm just going to select this and then Alt select this one and this one. You can see everything's selected. I'm going to press Shift D and then bring that over and then press R and Z and rotate it. So now we have like a second view of our sculpt. Maybe just move the camera over, give it a little bit more room. Just give it a little bit more room there. Okay, now if I press F12, because we are in the, you can see right here, because we're in Workbench, it just renders out the viewport. And I think right here on the resolution, I'm gonna make it 200. So that way when I render it, it's just gonna make a really nice, large, high detail image. So there we go. Let's just go file and save this again. And then I'm going to go image and click on save as image and just save this to my computer. Orc sculpt tutorial. I'll just save that image. So there we go. There is the tutorial on how to sculpt a orc head. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you for watching. If you followed along this tutorial and you want to show me your result, you can leave a link in the comments to your finished artwork. I'd love to see what you guys create. And these project files are going to be available on my Gumroad and Patreon. So the links will be in the video description if you want to check that out. And I'm also going to be uploading this 3D model to Sketchfab. So there will be a link in the video description as well to that model on Sketchfab if you want to check it out. But thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Have a great day, and I will see you in a future video.